If you are working for a school, college, university, or any other educational institute, you must be maintaining records of the students. Also, you will be maintaining the records of the fees collected. In today's video, we will see how to create a fee record sheet, which will be fully automated. This sheet will be connected with links and you can jump over the sheets just in a single click. Hi, my name is Vijay and you are watching Office Mom. Let's start the video without any delays. This is a student fee record of various classes like class 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th. Here are few things like roll number, name of the student, monthly fee, name of all the months from April till March, paid months means fees of how many months are already paid, pending months, fees of how many months are still pending, total paid fee and total balance fee is over here. On the top section, which can be managed by drop downs. Paid, due and NA means not applicable will be managed by dropdowns. From here, we will have to select from the dropdowns whatever is applicable. Once the fees will be paid, it will be showing in paid months. If the fees will not be paid, it will be showing in pending months. Once I'll delete all this, you will notice that paid months became 8 and pending months became 4. In pending months, you will notice that few months are green and few months are red. Currently, we are in the month of November, so ideally 4 months are still pending. So 4 months are green. If someone has not paid the fees before November, it's getting red over here. Few things are more over here like class. If I'll click on 7th, I'll jump to the record of class 7th. In the same way, once I click 8, I'll jump to record of class 8th, then 9th and then 10th. So let's start making a new sheet. We will start from 4th. So in the beginning, serial number, name, monthly fee. Here we will type name of the month and we will drag till March. On the top, we will go in format and we will adjust column width. Here we will type paid months, pending months, total paid, balance. We will select all 4 and we will adjust it. We will select the whole sheet and we will do formatting. We will increase the size of the cells. Over here, serial number. I'll create for 20 students. Name. You can insert name over here. Monthly fee. I'll take a random figure. I'll click over here. I'll do plus and I'll select this. Now I'll drag this till down. In case the fees changes, you will have to change in the first cell only and the total fees will get changed. In the months, we will create drop-down for paid, due and not applicable. For that, we will have to go in data, data validation. Here we will select the list and here we will type paid, comma, due, comma, NA and we will do OK. Our drop-down is created over here. We will drag this till March and for 20 students. So drop-down is already created. Now we will select all this and we will do conditional formatting. We will be going in home, conditional formatting, highlight cell rule, equal to, and here we will type paid. We want paid to be in green, so we will select green color, okay. Again, we will be going to conditional formatting, highlight cell rule, equal to, this time we will type due, and we want due in red color, so we will leave this, we will do okay. Again, we will be going to conditional formatting, highlight cell rule, equal to, and this time we will type NA means not applicable. Here we will select yellow color and we will do OK. So these things are managed now. Whenever we will select anything, it will take the color and we can select from drop down. We will do formatting of all this. We will remove the grid lines by going in view, show, and we will remove the grid lines. Now we will select from here till here and we will merge it. We will merge these two and we will merge these two also. Now we will insert the table. Here we will type monthly school fee record dash class 6th. Here we will type session and here we will create dropdown for the session. To create the dropdown again, we will have to go in data, data validation. We will select list. In source, we will type sessions which you want to create. So I'll be creating till 2030. Now we will do OK and the drop down for sessions is created. we can select from here. We will select all this. We will be going in home. We will select the color. We will change font color. We will change the font. We will take impact because it's bold. We will increase the size. Now we will insert formula for paid months, and the formula will be plus or equal to COUNTIF bracket open. We will select from April to March, comma, double inverted comma, paid, double inverted comma, close, bracket close, and we will do enter. Now we will drag this till down. Pending months. Formula for the pending months will be plus or equal to COUNTIF bracket open. We will select this, comma, double inverted comma, TU, double inverted comma, close, bracket close. Here we will count blanks also, because blank cells will be due. So we will have to do plus count blank bracket open. We will select from April to March bracket close, and we will do enter. Now we will drag this till down. In pending months, we will be counting two things, due and blank cells. Now we will be coming to total paid, and the formula will be plus or equal to paid months into fees. We will do enter. We will drag this till down. Balance. The formula for balance will be plus or equal to pending months into monthly fee. Enter. We will drag this till down. Now we will fill this so that we can calculate all the formulas very easily. I will adjust the size. Somewhere we will do due. Currently we are in November, so I'll delete this. Some parents pay fees in advance, so I'll drag this till March. I'll drag this also till March. Some students leave the school in the mid of the session, so we will do this NA, and we will drag this till end, due. So this thing is created now, and in the formulas of paid months, pending months, total paid and balance, it's getting calculated very properly. Now we will create the buttons. I'll take this in end. I'll drag this and I'll make it little bit bigger. We are going to create sheet for class 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th. Means we will have to insert total 5 buttons. We will be going in insert. Then we will be going in shapes, and we will take a shape from here. I'll click over here and our shape is inserted. Now I'll be going over here in shape effect, and I'll be going in bevel. I'll select this so that our shape looks like a button. Now we will copy this and paste it 5 times. We will make this bigger and we will type class. Over here, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th. I'll select all this. I'll increase the size of the font. I'll make the font bigger. I'll take this in center and in mid. We will select all this and we will arrange this. Align, distribute horizontally, and distribute vertically. If we want to give color to the edges of these buttons, we will have to select all this. We will have to go in shape format, and from here we will have to select the edge, color and weight. So color of the edges are here. Now we have to connect these sheets with these buttons. So we will select the whole sheet and we will copy it and we will paste in 4 different workbooks or worksheets. Here we will rename. First one was class 6. One is extra, so we will delete this. Now we will be coming to the first sheet of class 6 and we will color as white. Font color, we will keep it black. We will click on class 6. We will right click the mouse. We will go in link or hyperlink. You will get 3 options over here: web page or file, this document, email address. We have to click on this document. Now we have to click on class 6. And type in cell reference, you will get A1. So you will have to do OK. Again, you will have to go in class 7th, right click the mouse, link or hyperlink. Now this time select class 7, OK. Come in class 8, right click the mouse, link or hyperlink, select class 8th, OK. Class 9th, you will have to do the same thing, link or hyperlink, select class 9th, OK. Class 10. Hyperlink, select class 10th, do OK. We will change color of this thing. We will do it black. You will have to press Ctrl to select this. Our font color is changed now. Now first sheet got connected with all the sheets, but the remaining sheets are still not connected. So what we will have to do, we will have to select all this once again, Control C or Command C, and we will have to paste it over here once again in all the different worksheets. So this thing is done. This sheet is of class 10, so we will be going over here in class 6. We will press Control and we will do it blue, means we will do the color of the button as blue. Now we will be going in class 10, we will select this and we will do this white. We will have to do in all the classes. Now I will come in the first sheet and you will notice that all the sheets got connected. When I'll click on 7th, I'm on 7th class. When I'll click on 8th, I'm in 8th class. 9th, I'm on 9th class. 10th, I'm on 10th class. We can remove grid lines from all the sheets. So our monthly school fee record is created. You can create this for your school, college, university or any other educational institutes. I'm sure you must have loved the video. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. See you soon with a new topic. Till then, bye-bye.